A very warm welcome to you all on this Easter morn. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Thank you to all who have made this such a beautiful and splendid space for worship today. It's wonderful that you're here. Would you please stand to sing our first hymn? Peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthy magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God is love, and we are God's children. There is no room for fear in love. We love because God loved us first. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith. God, our Father, we confess to you and to our fellow members in the body of Christ that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry. Forgive us our sins and deliver us from the power of evil, for the sake of your Son who died for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. God, who is both power and love, forgive us and free us from our sins. Heal and strengthen us by the Holy Spirit and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We stand for the Kyrie eleison. And on this Easter day, the Gloria.
One God, now and forever.
Please sit for the readings.
The first reading is from Isaiah chapter 25, verses 6 to 9. Listen for the word of God. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-matured wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-matured wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The psalm is Psalm 118. Verses 1 and 2 and 14 to 24. The refrain is Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. And your response is, this is the day the Lord has made. Give thanks to the Lord. For he is good, his mercy endures forever. Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made.
The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. There is a sound of exultation and victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made.
I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them. I will offer thanks to the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made.
This is the gate of the Lord. Whoever is righteous may enter. I will give thanks to you, for you answered me and have become my salvation. The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. On this day the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made.
Next reading is from Acts chapter 10, verses 34 to 43. Listen for the word of God. Peter began to speak to those assembled in the house of Cornelius. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name.
Please stand for the hymn. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to Christ our Savior.
when the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early, on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. Give thanks to the Lord for his glorious gospel.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Please do sit down. If you've not already greeted the person behind, next to you, in front, and if that's okay with you, do wish them a happy Easter. Let's look at Mark's Gospel this morning. Mark's Gospel is a gospel of controversy. Some people didn't think it was finished, so they added a bit. Others think it finished. Were we finished with it today? During the 20th century, two New Testament scholars, one called John, one called Christopher, were talking about this. And they said, well, really? In the Jewish tradition, when you read a text, you read a scroll. And when you finish the scroll, you start again at the beginning. And the idea is, according to them, that when we hear this gospel, we are the ones who open the gospel story again and live it. It is up to us, you and I, to read this gospel story again, having been flabbergasted, amazed, awestruck, and fearful. And we read it again, seeking the Jesus within the stories.
Now, I'm not going to spend a long time at all talking about whether it really is the end or not. I can talk with you about that. I'm open to offers. I'm going to look, first of all, about two things that go together. The first one is anyone at all can be a follower of Jesus Christ. And let's be realistic. So the second thing is, no one finds that easy. And we're going to look at some of the people in the gospel today to look at that more deeply. Within Mark's gospel and throughout it, we have a reversal of what we expect, an inversion of values of the time. For the outsider in Jewish society is the Roman centurion, because he is present as an oppressor of the Jewish people. And so he is low down in society. And yet, he is the one who declared who Jesus is. We also have the presence of three women who are named. Mary, who is known by her children, and Salome. They were also low down in society by being women. And yet, the women are present throughout the gospel. We read about the women ministering to Jesus. The Greek word for ministering is like our word deacon. The women were the deacons who served. They are also known as the followers of Jesus. Very specific Greek word again. And if you are a follower of Jesus, then there is a commitment there. So the women who are seen sometimes are the ones who serve and minister and commit to Jesus. Now, Mark often worked in threes. The last time we saw someone dressed in white was up the mountain when Jesus was revealed in his glory at the Transfiguration or Metamorphosis with Peter, James, and John. Here we have Mary, and Salome. I wonder whether Mark is saying, you need to look a bit more carefully at this story. I am bringing into focus the women who have been present all along, but only on the edges. They will be the people who are given the message of the resurrection. They will be the first disciples. This reversal of what we expect continues. But alongside this, the women, just like Peter, are also ones who find following Jesus hard. We have Peter, and he follows Jesus at his arrest earlier in the scriptures, but he does so at a distance. He's not ready to say, I am a follower of Jesus. He's probably acting with a mixture of fear of what might happen to him, but also self-preservation. The women also watch the crucifixion at a distance. So following is not always easy. Now, with this focusing of the women, it is interesting. They are there at the crucifixion, at the empty tomb. They want to go and anoint Jesus, but I think in some ways they've already missed the plot, because Jesus has already been anointed at Bethany. They meet the young man dressed in the white robe, an angel, a representative of God. And they are tasked with passing on the message. So they really are brought into that focus. And if we look carefully at the text, we can tell more about their response. They are amazed. They are amazed in the way that people were amazed when Jesus healed people. They are astonished, like people were at Jesus' teaching, or flabbergasted. And also they are afraid, like the woman who touched Jesus' cloak and was healed. And Jesus said, "Who touched me?" These women are in on the action. And so, I wonder where you are in this text today. Are you someone who, because of who you are, has not really been seen as a follower of Jesus, and yet has faithfully been there throughout, experiencing the range of responses to Jesus? Are you one who finds following Jesus a challenge? Well, take heart, because Peter did, and Maria, and Salome did. You are in good company. Now, it's not clear whether the women who were told to go ahead to Galilee and tell Peter and the disciples did so or not. It's how you read the Greek. It's possible that they did tell Peter. It's just a little ambiguous. And so today, what are you going to do now you've heard the end of the story? Are you going to start again at the beginning? Alleluia, Christ is risen.
So we move to our prayers of intercession.
As followers of Christ, we come now to speak with the risen Christ, confident in the knowledge that the tomb is empty and he has ascended to sit at the right hand of God, where he intercedes on our behalf. As we stand and look at the empty tomb, gracious God, we are overwhelmed by your love for us. We thank you for the assurance that Christ is risen from the dead, now dwelling with you, removing our fear of death and bringing us to eternal life. May we, with Isaiah, proclaim that this is our God. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. With the psalmist, we bring you our thanks, knowing that your steadfast love endures forever, and we thank you that you have answered us and have become our salvation. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
graciously hear us. Loving God, Isaiah tells us that you will wipe away the tears from all faces, and so this morning we bring to you all those for whom the joy of Easter is meaningless. May they become aware of your immense love for them. Help us who share the resurrection assurance to work to spread the good news of you and of your love. Thank you for the progress made in the community garden. Please use that to your glory. Thank you for those who join us in story and song. May they learn of you and of your love for them. Encourage those who lead and those who help in those activities, guiding their actions and words. We pray that others may wish to join in and help in this work for you. Lord, hear us.
Lord
graciously hear us. God of peace, we know that your peace is beyond our human understanding. We thank you for the peace that only you can give, and pray now for peace. Peace in our hearts, peace in our relationships, peace in your church, and peace in your world. We know that in some parts of your world, peace seems far off, but we pray that your peace may spread throughout the world you have created. May leaders be led to seek peace, so that there may be an end to fighting and solutions to conflict actively sought. We pray for those whose lives have been disrupted by the effects of war, the bereaved, the homeless, the injured, the traumatized, the hungry, and the lost, asking that their various needs may be supplied and that they may know your peace in their lives. Keep us faithful in prayer for your world. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. This Easter morning, we thank you for your church here in Troon and throughout the world. Thank you for all those who have stood as witness to your love and grace over the years, and for all those who continue to serve you now, spreading the good news of your saving love. We thank you for our church community, both here in the building and any joining us in worship at home. We remember Kevin, our bishop, Reuben, our dean, and Keith, our rector. May they know your strength as they work for you. We pray for this congregation that we may know the joy of Easter and continue to worship and to follow and to thank you. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
graciously hear us. God of all healing, we pray for all those who suffer, whether in body, mind, or spirit. As we bring them to you now, we ask you to draw them close to you. Grant them your peace and healing as you deem fit. Give your comfort to the dying and surround the bereaved with your love. We do not know their needs, but you do. And so we bring them to you and leave them in your care. Challenge us to care as you would do, and help us to respond as you would wish us to. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
graciously hear us. Almighty God, who through your Son, Jesus Christ, has overcome death and opened the gates of eternal life, grant that we who celebrate with joy the day of his resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen.
Yesterday evening, we had a wonderful Easter vigil service within the church on behalf of Troon Churches Together. And as part of that, we renewed our baptism vows with our friends from across Troon. And we also commissioned two new pastoral assistants for St. Ninian's Troon. This is truly an important occasion within the life of the church. And so we have commissioned on behalf of the bishop and in accordance with the agreement and support of the vestry, Julia and Dorothy to work with me in pastoral care within this place. Yes, pastoral care of those in need, the sick, the infirm, but also pastoral care of fostering a community of wholeness. And I'm just going to ask Dorothy and Julia just to stand up, please, just in case you don't know who they are, to turn around and face everyone. Thank you very much indeed. Can we give them a clap, please, and welcome them? I'm very conscious if I tipped you off, you might not have got up. So thank you very much indeed. Will you remember them in your prayers, please? Please stand for the peace. We meet in Christ's name. Thank you. we respond to God's overwhelming generosity and love with our own generosity as we sing the offertory hymn. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become the cup of our salvation. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Worship and praise belong to you, author of all being. Your power sustains, your love restores our broken world. You are unceasingly at work. From chaos, bringing order, and fulfilling and filling emptiness with life. Christ, raised from the dead, proclaims the dawn of hope. He lives in us that we may walk in light. Your spirit is fire in us. Your breath is power to purge our sin and warm our hearts to love. As children
of your redeeming purpose, freed by him who bursts from the tomb and opened the gate of life. We offer you our praise with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. For by the cross eternal life is ours, and death is swallowed up in victory. In the first light of Easter, glory broke from the tomb and changed the women's sorrow into joy. From the garden the mystery shone clear, that he whom they had loved and lost is with us now in every place forever. Making himself known in the breaking of the bread, speaking peace to the fearful disciples, greeting fishermen on the shore, he renewed the promise of his presence and of new birth in the Spirit, who sets a seal of freedom on your sons and daughters. Before he was given up to suffering and death, recalling the night of Israel's release, the night in which slaves walked free. At supper with his disciples, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by your Spirit's life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son. And we may be kindled with the fire of your love and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, until at last in your new creation we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. The living bread is broken for the life of the world.
Lord, unite us in this time.
As our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Give thanks to our gracious God. God of life, bring us to the glory of the resurrection promised in the Easter sacrament. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the risen Lord. Amen. Amen. Loving God, your steadfast purpose is the completion of all things, your Son. May we who have received the pledges of the kingdom live by faith, walk in hope, and be renewed in love until the world reflects your glory and you are all in all. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thine be the glory. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Please do come to the hall following the service this morning for refreshments and for chocolate. We will also consecrate the next stage in our community garden, Ninian's garden, the peace of God, which passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.